Hi, my name is Dr. Arun Dhir. I'm a gastrointestinal and a weight loss surgeon and a passionate health and wellness advocate. As you're already aware, we are in the midst of a global pandemic. Coronavirus has taken over the center of our lives. We are fighting over toilet paper. That is indeed sad, and I know that we all have to prepare ourselves to the best. However, the purpose of this video is to shed some light on the implications this might have on a forthcoming surgery that you might have, and what can you do to boost your healing and your immune system today. And these approaches that I'm going to be talking about towards the end of the video will apply to regardless whether you're having surgery or not. Now, friends, there is a very nice quote which says that what you resist persists. Now, that is so true that we are, the fear is being planted in our minds through media, through news, through newspapers, and all the conversations they are having. But what I want to share with you is that yes, absolutely, you prepare yourself. And if you've got any symptoms, go and get it checked, get tested, and get the right advice. But what is more important is you also got to know that your gut is the seat of your immune system. There is an immunoglobulin called IgA. This is the most powerful antibody that your mucous membranes make. The mucous membranes of the eyes, these are the inner linings of your mouth and other areas which produce this antibody called IgA, which is the most powerful antiviral antibody that your body produces. So, what the relevance of this is, especially in the context of, say, if you are planning on an elective surgery, elective means planned surgery, explore the option with your treating doctors and surgeons whether the surgery can be postponed, understanding that these are kind of very unpredictable times. Even they are talking about shortage of masks in theaters, such that, you know, that's essential equipment that is there. So it may be prudent to consider postponing your elective surgery. However, the second and the more important thing that I want to state is that work on your immune system, on recalibrating and rebalancing your immune system such that it functions optimally. Now, I have five key strategies, very simple strategies that I can suggest to you straight away, which will really help you boost your immune system. Number one, drink plenty of water, and this water has to be filtered. At least 1 to 1.5 liters every day of filtered water. Radical hydration allows your body to function optimally, and this applies to the immune system. Number two, eat whole immune boosting foods such as natural fruits, berries, especially blueberries, strawberries, forest berries, and nuts. But more importantly, also avoid very processed foods like sugars, pizzas, burgers, sausages, and those kind of things, because they are not good for your immune system. They are not good for you, generally speaking. Number three, load up on vitamin C. Now, vitamin C is called the nature's antioxidant, most powerful antioxidant, and it also is extremely boosting and uplifting for your immune system. What you can do is, simplest thing is, squeeze lemon on anything that you are consuming, if it is appropriate. Such as you're having a risotto, you can squeeze some lemon juice on it. You know, it should be fresh lemon juice, or have citrus fruits like oranges and things like that. Number four, make sure that you're getting good quality sleep. 6 to 8 hours of sleep is essential for your immune system to function optimally. And the last and the most important one is, learn to manage your stress better. Things like meditation, things like taking a walk in nature are really stress relieving exercises that can, or activities that can help you manage your stress better. See, we all have stress, but we all need to learn how to manage stress better. And the last thing, if I can say, is don't just stick to the television. Research has proven that people who watch a lot of television, especially the news and what's happening and all of that, have a higher level of anxiety. They just have this fear that we don't know what's going to happen next because you are caught up in that mesh. So I'm hoping that these five things will boost your inner healing and it will allow you to fight off this potential threat of coronavirus, even if you're exposed to it. And if you are coming to surgery and if you do happen to have surgery, well, it will certainly boost your healing abilities. So hope you find this information useful. Please make sure that you share it with your friends and family and make sure that you put these into practice. Take care and have a blessed day.